Lost Property by Katie Himms. Part 1. The Wrong Label.
Queenie?
Yeah?
You know when you die?
Yeah.
What do you think it feels like?
Depends how you die, doesn't it?
But do you think you can feel it happening?
Well, that depends how quick it is.
I suppose.
If there's no time, if you, like, get wiped out in a flash, how can you feel anything at all?
I don't know.
Ray! Queenie!
Yeah?
Yeah?
Stop talking about death!
We can't help it.
We can't stop ourselves.
Play a game. Play I Spy.
In here?
Well, why not?
There's nothing to spy except spiders.
What do you think Hitler's doing right now?
I've no idea.
Probably having his tea in peace with no bombs or anything.
I hope my wedding china's all right.
You never use it.
Because I don't want it to get smashed.
If you never use it, you're not going to miss it, are you?
I like looking at it. I just like looking at it. Shh, Ella May. Oh, darling, don't be scared, Ella May. See, you've scared Ella May now.
How have we scared Ella May?
Talking about death.
She doesn't even know what death is.
Mama.
It's a long way to Tipperary.
Mama.
It's a long way to go.
If we die...
Yeah?
Tonight. I mean, if we die tonight...
Yeah?
Do you think we'll go straight to heaven?
I don't know.
I don't want to go to purgatory.
I don't want to go to purgatory either.
Maybe if you get killed by a bomb, you can just skip that bit and go straight to heaven. As like a reward.
Maybe.
If we knew, then I wouldn't mind thinking about the dying bit.
Maybe we're dead already.
Do you think we are?
Maybe we died and we just don't know it. And this is purgatory.
It was 11 p.m. on the 7th of September, 1940. This was the night that changed everything. When the bombing really began in earnest. If bombing could ever be described as earnest. Earnest sounds far too nice a term for it, really. The gas main running down the middle of Beckton Road was hit. Warehouses on both sides of the Thames were hit. Sugar, timber, rope, textiles, alcohol, spirits and paints all caught fire. And thousands of fleeing rats were drowned in the river.
Did you see that?
I saw it.
But did you see it?
Yes.
Do you think there were people inside when it happened?
I don't know, Ray.
How do you think they got them out?
With very great difficulty.
The big red bus lay on its side in a giant crater as if it had flown from the earth to the moon. On the side was a poster, which you could read even now. The poster urged mothers to send their children away, beseeched them. And there was Hitler whispering into the mother's ear, telling her she needn't bother. These posters had been making Alice feel bad for months. Like she wasn't a good mother for keeping her children at home. Like she wasn't making her contribution to the war effort.
Number 22's gone.
I can see.
When they brought the little girl out, she was near perfect. Not a mark on her. Like angel she was.
Can you please not talk like that in front of the kids? What's wrong with you?
On a second night in a waterlogged Anderson shelter full of spiders, Alice decided this was no way for her children to die. Her own life was another matter. Her own life was her own business. Sometimes she felt that she wouldn't mind being obliterated. Sometimes she felt that obliteration might suit her very well. Alice was not one of life's positive thinkers, even though she worked in a sugar factory.
I'm not going.
Can you eat your dinner?
What is it exactly?
Just eat it, Ray.
I'll eat it if you tell me what it is.
It's an omelette.
It doesn't look like an omelette.
Can you just eat it, please?
You can't make me go.
If you don't go, who's going to look after Ray? Who's going to look after Ella May?
Well, they're not going either. None of us are. We're staying here. We're staying put.
We're staying put.
Like hell you are.
You shouldn't use words like hell in front of your children.
Do you think I like it? Do you think this is what I want?
Yeah.
Then you're stupid. Stupider than I thought.
You just don't love us. That's what it is.
Is that true?
Dad wouldn't make us go.
Well, he's not here, is he?
More's a pity.
You're going. That's all there is to it.
No, we're not.
You bloody are.
You shouldn't swear.
I'll swear if I bloody well want to.
You're the only mother I know that swears. Other people's mothers don't swear.
That's why I'm special.
Special's one word for it.
Other people's children respect their elders, but not you, Queenie McCarthy. Not you.
Well, that's why I'm special.
It says here that mustard gas smells faintly of onions, horseradish or garlic. What's garlic?
I have no idea.
But how will we know what that smells like?
Queenie.
What?
Don't let go of LMA.
I won't.
Make sure you don't.
How long are we going for?
Not too long.
But how long's that?
A few weeks, a few months, maybe.
A few months?
Maybe. I don't know, Ray.
What if we hate it?
Oh, you won't hate it. You won't. It will sort of be like a holiday.
Will there be sea?
Sea?
Will we be at the seaside?
I don't know. That depends.
Will we have ice cream?
I don't know, Ray. Maybe.
Will there be cows?
Yeah, I suppose so.
Ronnie Stoker's mum says the countryside is unnatural.
The important thing is to stick together. Promise me that you'll stick together.
We promise.
Queenie?
We promise.
You all need to write me a postcard. When you get to where you're going, you ask the nice lady you're staying with to help. You let me know where you are and what your address is, etc.
How will we know what the address is?
Well, the nice lady will tell you.
What's her name?
We don't know yet.
We haven't met her yet. She might not even be nice, the nice lady.
What did you say that for? Of course she'll be nice. Why shouldn't she be nice?
Not everyone is nice, though, are they? Not everyone can go and stay with someone nice. Some people have to go and stay with someone nasty.
Just don't let go of LMA.
I won't.
Promise me.
I promise.
Don't let go of her.
I said I won't. How many times do you want me to say it?
100 times. Say it 100 times.
That'll take ages.
They were stood on the platform. Gorgeous, heart-stopping Queenie. Good-natured, big-hearted Ray. And the mysterious, otherworldly LMA. They had their labels, their gas masks, their spam sandwiches, their change of clothes, their postcard. Queenie also had a copy of her favourite book, Wuthering Heights. Ray had his magic marbles, and Ella May had her doll with the china face and the pink ribbon, who she inexplicably called Puh. There were lots of children and lots of mothers crying, but Alice wasn't one of them.
Parents not allowed on the platform, Mrs. McCarthy?
Oh.
It's because of the emotion.
Sorry?
You can't have too much emotion on the platform, Mrs. McCarthy. It's not good for the children.
Right. I loved him.
So they said a very quick goodbye.
Look after each other,
a yeah. Goodbye that didn't seem nearly good enough, in fact.
Gotta go with LMA.
Your sister needs to go over there.
What?
It's pardon, Queenie, and your sister needs to go in the other line.
No, my mum said LMA's got to stay with me.
All children under school age are to wait in a different line and travel in a different carriage.
But why?
Because that's the way of it, Queenie. Now don't argue. Take your sister to the other line and return here.
I need LMA to stay with me.
We're not supposed to let go of her.
Children under school age need to be supervised.
I'll supervise her.
I'll supervise her too.
I'm afraid that's not possible. All the little ones are to go together, and all the big ones are to go together. Your sister will be quite safe, you know, and you'll be reunited after the train journey. She'll be quite all right, I assure you.
Well, I should have thought of something.
There wasn't time.
If she gets lost, Mum will blame me.
Do you think she'll get lost?
I hope not.
People don't get lost. Things get lost, but not people.
Oh, we should have put her inside the suitcase.
Then where would we have put everything else that was in the suitcase?
I don't know.
And she might have suffocated.
Oh, Mum's going to kill me.
It's not your fault.
Doesn't matter. She'll still kill me.
I'll tell her. I'll say. We can blame Mr. Nightingale. If it's anyone's fault, it's his. Well, him or Hitler. Don't worry, Queenie. It'll be all right in the end.
In a way, Ray was right. It would be all right in the end. But the end was about 70 years away from this point in time, which is a long way off by anyone's count. Unless you were thinking about how long the dinosaurs were on Earth, and then, of course, it's quite short, really.
What are they singing?
It's Welsh.
What's Welsh?
Well, they're singing.
Can you understand what they're saying?
No.
Why can't we understand them?
Because they're singing in Welsh, in the Welsh language.
Is there a Welsh language?
I don't know anything, do you?
And now, Mrs. Price will sing a special song for the children.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.